Good morning. Glory to God. The Lord has been faithful. He has brought us thus far. His name be praised. By the grace of God this morning, we'll be listening and hearing a short exhortation. That is topic, righteousness is a gift. Let's pray. Father, thank you, worship you, give you praise. Lord, even as we hear this exhortation, may you exalt our life and put our equal in the name of Jesus. Transform us into light and take away darkness from our path and sight in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. By His grace, we have been looking at what grace is in our previous exhortation for some days now. But this morning, we shift our focus to righteousness. Righteousness is a gift. That is our topic. Just as grace is the gift of God, righteousness is also a gift. Our text is from Luke chapter 18, 9 to 14. We'll be reading verse 9 of Luke chapter 18. And he spake this parable unto certain which trusted in themselves that they were righteous and despised others. The gift of righteousness is what give. It is what is given to those who trust in Him by Christ. Christ offered this gift of righteousness to those, just as it was said. He said, it is of God that no man should boast, that the righteousness is of God. People who are self-righteous often despise others. They cannot compare themselves to Jesus and feel good about themselves. So, in order to trust in themselves, they have to constantly compare themselves to other fallible people. This breed is a critical attitude that exalts themselves by debasing others. No one can ever be righteous in the sight of God through their own righteousness. Our righteousness, or rather our actions, benefit us in relationship with people and prevent Satan from having an opportunity against us. But they cannot make us right with God. We must receive His gift of righteousness completely on the basis of faith in what Jesus did for us. This is the truth that this parable is presenting. Most people are unaware that there are two kinds of righteousness, and only one type of righteousness is accepted or acceptable to God. There is our own righteousness, which is based on our own performance, and there is God's righteousness, which is based on Jesus' performance. God's righteousness is not something that you do, but something you receive as a gift when you put your faith in Jesus Christ. The moment you believe God raised him from the dead and said, Jesus, you are my Lord, the Holy Spirit transformed your spirit and made you righteous. As righteous as Jesus. When your way has been retrieved by God, when you decide to follow the path, God retrieves your step and God places the seed of righteousness in you. It's for you to follow his path. When you follow his path, he also transforms you. He said he has taken us from darkness into the marvelous light. So you will not live into the life of Jesus. He said when we are baptized, we are baptized into the death, and we were also brought out. We are risen with him from death. So we have been put right. The term righteousness represents being put right with Jesus. And it can only be possible when we believe in what he has done, what he has came to fulfill, for we to obtain that righteousness. His death, his coming, his redemption to the world. When you believe on this, you begin to enjoy the gift of righteousness, not your performance, just as the Pharisees did. Today, celebrate your standing with God this entire day by the grace of God. The Lord bless his word in our hearts. I pray the Lord will give us the grace not to rely on our own strength, but to rely on God's strength always. By the grace of God, I remain Joshua Osatohanmwen. Join me tomorrow for another exhortation like this. Till then, stay blessed.